Hello and welcome. In this lesson, we'll be looking at the best left-hand piano patterns if you want to sound elegant and sophisticated. So if you're looking for the best left-hand piano pattern accompaniment for piano, left-hand piano chords to accompany any melody, and you want to sound elegant and sophisticated, then keep watching. Don't forget to snag your free 100-day practice challenge and free chord guide, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you won't miss a lesson. So if you're ready, let's get started.
I can't wait to share with you these left-hand accompaniment patterns. I use these all the time, and I suggest that you follow along with me and then incorporate them and make them your own. So we're gonna start really simple, and the first one is just a chord that I've arpeggiated. And arpeggiated means instead of playing the chord all three notes together, we're gonna roll the chord. So it sounds like this. And then if you wanna roll the entire chord, it sounds like that. So that is a super simple way to add a left-hand pattern. So this is my other really favorite left-hand pattern. So it starts on C, and then we go up to the octave and we play C, D, B, C. And I know this sounds a little bit as if it's kind of falling off, but if you want to create a very ambient sound, this pattern is amazing. So let's practice it together one more time. It's C, C, D, C, B, C. And if you want to add a little right hand in, you can. So something that simple, just adding a little melody in the right hand, totally changes the whole atmosphere. And this is why I really like this left-hand pattern so much. This next left-hand pattern, I would say it's more common, but I still find myself reaching for it quite often. So it's just the C, G, and D. And then when you get up to that C, you're gonna rock back and forth between the C, G, C, G, C, G. So it sounds like this. And all I'm doing is rocking back and forth between the G and the C. Okay, now let me show you what it sounds like if I were to add a couple chords with my right hand. So it might sound like this. And you see with my right hand, I just added any random chords. And with this type of left-hand accompaniment, everything sounds good. So this next left-hand accompaniment, I don't know, I mean, I love them all, but this one I like especially. So this one actually goes above the octave. So it's C, G, C, D, E. And then you're gonna hold that last note for two counts. Again, I'm in 4/4 time. You could play this in 2/4 or other time signatures, but just to keep things pretty simple, we're gonna play one, two, and that's all you have to do. Just rock your hand and roll it up to E and hold it and back down again. And to me, it almost sounds hypnotic. So if I were to play this pattern, I think I would keep my right hand relatively sparse and simple because the left hand is so mysterious and beautiful on its own. So I might play something like this. Now you see why I like this pattern so much. So I wasn't planning on sharing this pattern with you, but again, I don't know why, but this pattern as well is just so beautiful. So let me explain this one to you because it might look a little bit different than normally what you see on paper. So I'm sure you've heard it before, but this is how you play it. You play C, and then you hold the C down, and then you play the E and the B. Okay, so you tie the C over. So C, hold the C, and then play the E and the B. Now, there's a second part to this one. You play it again, the C, but this time, instead of playing the B, you play the A. So E and A. So it's C, E and B, C, E and A, okay? And to me, this sounds as if I were on, I don't know, a boat kind of moving back and forth, and it just sounds really calming. So let me play it for you one more time. So if I were to add again my right hand, I would keep it pretty simple, but again, I want to give you these left hand patterns so you can make them your own, whether you're improvising or composing, or let's say you have a popular melody and you want to change it up a little bit with your own left hand accompaniment. This would be the perfect pattern. So I would play something like, one thing you should remember is that you can always play a pattern and then create a variation of that pattern. So here's a perfect example. So the pattern that we just played, instead of holding the C down and then playing the E and the B and then the C and then the E and A, we're going to arpeggiate that chord. So it's going to sound like this. One little element and set up the tie to an arpeggiated chord. I mean, in my mind, it just sounds completely different. So let me show you how I might add a melody to that. Congratulations, you've completed this lesson. See you in the next lesson.